Welcome back everyone. So in today's video, I'll be showing you how you can insert or embed a video into your prototype. So for this, I'll be using the Adobe XD and Anima plugin. So to demonstrate this, I've created a small animation of a video gallery module. So let's quickly have a demo of what we're going to build today and then we can get started. So here we are on a screen now and I've opened up the prototype. So this is a video gallery. It has some videos here. So I'll click on the first one here. As you can see, that opened up, that was a cool animation. And now I'll click on play. So as you can see, the video is running and the playhead is moving and we reach on a replay mode here. So let's see how we can create this. So moving on to Adobe XD here, I've opened up a new project. So this video is mainly focused on how to insert or embed a video and create this animation. So I won't be showing you the whole process of creating the UI here. So I've already created this video player module as a component. This has various components as let me just show you the different things we have in this. So here we have a playhead and let me just show you. So yeah, these are the controls. So apart from the controls, I also have a title. So let me just turn this on. So here we have a title and a timer. So that is one part. And in this itself, I also have a replay button and a play button. And here I also have a pause button. So those are the different things we have in this component. So let's quickly, I'll just fast forward this part and I'll quickly create the UI and then we can see how to do it. So here we are done with creating the UI and this is not pixel perfect at all because the main focus of this video is to see how we can insert or embed a video. So I just quickly try to create this thing. So now let's see how we can insert a video. So for that, I'll just duplicate this and then this video is to be focused. So I'll just bring it to the center here and now let's expand it. I think this one looks okay. And along with this, there is one more thing which has to happen, that the overlay has to come in. So let's bring in the overlay to, let's say, 70 looks good. So yeah, 70. And the title, as you know, it has to hide and the controls have to come in. So I turn the opacity of the title down and let me just bring up the opacity of the controls. So here we have the controls and everything looks good. So now let's duplicate this to create the next state. So in the next state, what should happen is when we click on the play button, this play button would go away. So there it goes. And the play button here would change into a pause button. So here we have the play button. So this one goes down and where's the pause button? Yeah. So the pause button comes in. So this is to a 75%. And next off, the video needs to come in here. For that, we will be adding it through the Anima plugin. But before that, we need one more state here. So I'll be telling the use of this. So this is the next state I'm creating is for actually the playhead to move, but we need to add the video in these two cases because this is the initial state and this is the end state. So the video needs to be on both, but let me just create the final state also and then we can talk about the video. So I duplicate this and this is going to be our final state where basically your playhead is on the total end and your blue bar is completely filled, and your play button again comes in and your pause button goes out. And also we need to have a replay button here, so our controls come back and your replay button comes in. So yeah, now we are done with all the states. So now let's see how we can add the video into this. So for that, you need to go to the plugins and you need to add a plugin called as Anima. So just search for Anima plugin and you will find this. So I've already installed it, or else you'll get an install button. So this is how the plugin looks. So what I'll do is in the two states where we need to insert a video, just select the box here and go to video. So here you need to give a video link basically. So you can actually, if it is a small video or something, you can directly upload it to Anima and do it. Or else you can choose some video from the web itself. So if you go to upload, this is where you come in. Oh, okay, it's loading. So this is where you come in. You can actually upload your video and here you get the video. You can take the URL from here and give it there. Or else you can just search for some sample video. So you get many sample videos here. So if you go to the site here, there are many sample videos. You can either select from something from here, just copy the link. So I've already uploaded it here. So let me just copy this one itself. So I'll just say copy. And then I can come back here and just insert the link. And then what you got to do is we need an autoplay option selected, because during the animation, you don't want to click a play button. So this one's activated. A loop is also a better option. If it ends before the animation, that would loop it again. And I don't need any controls and I want everything to fill the screen. So I go for a cover fill and I do a save. So that's it. We have the video in this. Let's do the same thing on this one also. So I go ahead and I select the video. I paste the URL. I select all these options and I save it. So we have the video set in place. So the next thing is, in this state also, the playhead has to move forward. So let's do that one also. So I move the playhead till here and I move the play bar here. So we have our state set. Now let's link up the whole prototype screens. So for the first thing, I go to prototype and I select the play button here. And I link it to the next one. So this should be an auto animate. So let's keep it like 0.8 seconds so that it smoothly comes and zooms in. And then we need to select this one and give it to the next one. And let's say auto animate. Yeah, that looks good. But let's change the duration to 0.2 seconds. And now the video would start playing. So we need to set the whole thing with a timer function. So I go here and I select this to this one, the whole screen, and I set the trigger point as time. And let's say I want the video to run for 5 seconds. Basically, you can't go beyond 5 seconds if I'm not wrong. So once I set that, I would give the duration as 5. So the video would run for 5 seconds here. And in that 5 seconds, you can also see this playhead moving. So that is why I've given 5. And this should happen in a linear motion. You don't want to ease in and ease out because the timer moves in a linear pattern. So I go ahead and select the easing option as none, which is basically a linear one. And once that is done, I would link this one with the next one again as a timer trigger. And maybe you want the duration to be just 0.2 seconds, and that would transition to this with an auto animate. So I think we are pretty much done and it should work as we expect it to work. So let's quickly go ahead and check how it works. So first we'll do a preview in basically Adobe XD, and then we can see how it works on Anima. So here we have a screen, and then I select that. I click on the play option. Our playhead is moving properly. So here you won't be able to see the video. For that, we need the Anima plugin. So everything is working fine. So now what we can do is let's jump ahead and see how it works on Anima. So I select all the screens here, but before that, you need to select the first screen and set it as home, because this is the first one you want to see on your prototype. And once that is done, just go ahead and select all your screens. And I would create a new project here. So let's say sample player, and I would select a workspace. This is a free plan. You can upload up to 2 projects if I'm not wrong. So I go ahead and create a project here, and a project is created and it's selected. So what you have to do now is just select all your screens and say preview in browser. So this is basically uploading all your project screens to Anima, and then we can see the prototype running there. Not only videos, you can insert in GIF animations, you can insert latte animations, and there are various options here. So let me know in the comments below if you want to see some videos on more about the Anima plugin, and we can do that. So there you go, your prototype draft is ready. You just need to click on open here, and that opens up in your browser. So there we go, we have our screens loaded up, and then we can just click on this. And you have the player, just click on play, and the video runs very smoothly, and then it goes to the replay option. So that's it guys for this video. If you like the video, do leave a thumbs up below, or let me know in the comments below what you want to see next, and we can work on that. And as always, if you like the video, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to click the bell icon. Thanks for watching.